A young girl abandoned in Odessa years ago facing serious medical problems is given a second chance by a Midland family.
CBS 7's Bo Berman joins us now to explain how, after a brush with death, there appears to be a light at the end of the tunnel. It's all new tonight at 10 o'clock. Bo?
Unknown is exactly how little Anita Cole ended up without a kidney, stranded in Odessa. But what's very certain is that after years of medical turmoil, a loving family, and some luck, she's healthy once and for all. 14-year-old Anita Cole looks like your average American teenager, but Cole, born in Mexico and abandoned in Odessa without a kidney by age 4, has faced anything but a normal life.
She's had heart failure, that she was in cardiac arrest. She was in the emergency room and they were performing CPR on her for almost 3 hours.
Midland couple Gary and Anita Cole met Anna when she was 7, only to adopt her later on, despite major kidney problems requiring dialysis treatment 4 hours a day, 3 times a week.
She's been through all of this whole journey in her life, and she doesn't complain.
Necessity forced Anna and Anita to spend a year in Cook Children's Hospital in Fort Worth, away from Gary, awaiting a kidney transplant.
There's a kidney that's probably a good match for you. You're 16th on the list.
At one point, Anna went into cardiac arrest, and after hours of CPR, doctors were about to give up, only for Anna to wake up. After surviving a tough situation once again, Anna got a new kidney 2 weeks ago.
And she said, "Daddy, I got a kidney." I mean, it's special. So as long as she keeps the kidney healthy and keeps taking her medications, she's got to take the anti-rejection meds the rest of her life. And she could have the kidney for years and years and years.
Next month, Anna and Anita will return to Midland and live together with Gary as a family once again.
One of Anna's wishes was that she had a mommy and a daddy.
For the next 4 to 6 weeks, Anna needs to get checkups in Fort Worth 3 times a week, so it's undetermined when she'll head back to Midland. But when she does, her father says friends plan to welcome her back in the streets with a large banner. Reporting in the studio, Bo Berman, CBS 7 News.